Hello guys, welcome to TenorShare channel. Since Apple released the iOS 15 beta, a lot of people have already installed the latest beta version to have an experience. However, for some people the experience is not pleasing. Some friends might have come across FaceTime crashes, talk screen lag, Wi-Fi connectivity issues, or other annoying problems. It is good to know that there are ways for you to downgrade your iDevices to a more stable version, iOS 14. Today I'm gonna introduce 3 top iOS downgrade tools for you and instruct you step by step to get your iPhone back to iOS 14. Now let's begin. Preparation. Before downgrading your iPhone, you will need to prepare 3 things: a computer, your iPhone, and a cable to connect your iPhone with your computer. It doesn't matter whether you are using Windows system or macOS system, the methods in the next chapter will give you answers to solve the problem. For Windows users, you can use iTunes to downgrade iOS 15 beta. Firstly, plug the cable in your iPhone and connect it to the computer. Open any web browsers and go to this website. Just click your device model, and here you can download the IPSWA file for iOS 14 and hit download. If there is no response when you click download, you can copy the link here and paste it in the address bar. Now it is downloading. This will cost you some time. After that, launch iTunes. You can see your iPhone information here. Check this computer so that the computer will be your backup location. Then click Backup Now. Wait until the process is done. Then, go to the iTunes backup folder. It is under this address. Scroll all the way down and find info.plist. Open it. Press Ctrl plus F. Type product to search for the word. Below the product version, change 15 to 14 because we want it to match the iOS 14 system. Then save this file and go back to iTunes. Before restoring your iPhone, go to the settings of your phone and turn off Find My. This will help make sure the downgrade goes smoothly. Now hold down Shift key and click Restore iPhone. Select the IPSWA file you just downloaded. It says that iTunes will erase and restore your iPhone. Don't worry, we have just backed up the phone, and we will get the data back after restoring it. So hit restore. During this process, just leave your iPhone connected and wait your iPhone to restart. Your iPhone has been downgraded to iOS 14. After making some quick settings, the device asks us how we want to transfer apps and data. Press restore from Mac or PC. Now you can see the backup selection in iTunes. This is the backup we created just now. Click continue. When it's done, your iPhone will be back to iOS 14, and your data will be kept as well. For macOS users, Finder can help you with the downgrade. Just like what we do before, connect your iPhone with Mac. Go to this site, choose your device model, and download the IPSWA file for downgrading. Launch Finder on your Mac. You can see your device has been connected. Check this box. It will back up all of the data on your iPhone to the Mac. Click Backup Now. Wait for Finder to back up your data. When it is finished, hit Manage Backups. Your backup information will appear here. Right-click to locate the file place. Find the info.plist and open it. Just like what we did with iTunes, press Ctrl plus F, search for the word product, and modify 15 to 14. Remember to save the file. This will make our backup match with the iOS 14. It is time to restore our iPhone. There is a difference between Windows and macOS. In Windows system, you need to hold down Shift and click it. While in here, you need to hold down Option and click Restore iPhone. Now select the IPSWA file we downloaded and hit Restore. After that, the familiar hello screen will appear on your iPhone. After some quick settings on your device, press Restore from Mac or PC again, then go back to Finder. Select the backup we created just now. Continue, this will bring back the iOS 14 successful without losing your data. There is another wonderful tool I would like to recommend. It is the ReiBoot software. It is available on both Windows and macOS system. Windows 7 or older versions and macOS 10.9 or later versions are all included. If you think iTunes or Finder is too complicated, ReiBoot will be a more easy and convenient way for you to operate. Now let's figure out how it works. On TenorShare's official website, you can find a product. you can free download Tenorshare ReiBoot and install it on your computer. Downgrade process will erase your data. You can either use iTunes or Finder to back up your device, as we mentioned earlier. Now let's move to the next step. Restore your iPhone. Connect your iPhone to your computer with a cable. Open ReiBoot. The software will automatically identify your device version. Click Start. Choose Standard Repair for downgrading. Now you need to import the IPSWA file we downloaded from IPS.me manually. Then click Start Standard Repair. Choose Deeper Repair. Don't worry about your data. We have backed up already, and we will get it back after the repair. When the repair progress is finished, your iPhone is now back to iOS 14. Well, iOS 15 beta still has some problems while using. Indeed, some problems are really annoying. At least now you have learned the ways to downgrade the system, which can offer you more choices. If you find this video useful, please subscribe and give us a big thumb up. Hope you enjoy this video. This is Tenorshare channel. See you in the next one.